Back in 2014, Tom came to Labor Education Service with the idea of making a documentary about the farmer labor movement. He was president and is of the Farmer Labor Education Committee. And so he and Anna and I have been working on and off on this project all that time. And many, many other people contributed to the project. We certainly can't name them all. Some of them show up in the credit roll at the end, but I encourage you to actually go to the Farmer Labor Education Committee website, which you'll see a slide for later on, just to see the scores and scores of people that helped us produce this show. And I think that's it for now. I just want you to have a chance to see it. And after working largely just among ourselves, it's really nice to share it with an audience. And thank you all so much for coming. A lot of you contributed to this show. So here we go.
The issue really is the existence of the union itself. That is, it's very difficult. They don't want the union around. No employers particularly want the union around. They'd much rather have people operating by themselves, fragmented, isolated, alone, so they can be controlled and manipulated. The union, essentially, is the response of teaching assistants and students on this campus to that situation. They found that they were alienated from the institution. They couldn't do anything, so they came together to try to do something about it. That's a force. That's a counter-institution to this institution.
The strike began on March 16, 1970. TAA members set up picket lines outside classroom buildings, urging students not to cross them.
Unless we refuse to let the police intimidate our picket line, everything will come through. It's only when we establish good labor picket lines that we're going to stop things from coming through. Trucks are coming up, and they say, damn it, don't ask us to stop. If you tell us to stop, we can. And they're turning around and leaving.
The strike of the Madison TA represents not only an extension of campus radicalism into the teaching staff and a crystallization of it in organizational form and concerted action. More than that, it indicates, it symbolizes, it presages a fusion of that academic proletariat with the ferment among the other sections of the public employees. That means with the organized labor movement, which is the decisive social force and the ultimate power that can change this whole rotten war-making system. The Madison TAs are out to win. They deserve to win. But win, lose, or draw at this point, you have shown how to resist academic exploitation. You've asserted the power of your numbers as a union. You've blazed a trail that teaching assistants in other universities will certainly learn and profit from. Vince Ramos.
All right.